number one, initiating a new simulation lesson. First of all, let me click on this icon to open the application. This is the interface of our software or our simulator. We have inside this simulator a lot of modules and lessons, and we will pick one of them. Click here on custom use. We have a lot of lessons or modules, and in this lab we need only this lesson, aerodynamics module or lesson. Just drag and drop it here. Okay, and then click here, launch this lesson. Okay. Now we have a jet engine with its own parts. We are concerned today in the thermodynamic devices. We have here a compressor and a turbine. If we look at this 3D model, you will find that the airflow will enter the engine from the inlet. After that, it will reach to the compressor inlet. We have here a centrifugal compressor. The difference between the centrifugal compressor and the axial compressor is that if the flow comes to the compressor and completes the way straightforward, that means the compressor is axial compressor. But in this case, the flow comes to the compressor and it changes its direction radially, right? So it's a centrifugal compressor. Then the flow will come here to the combustion chamber. This chamber contains a sprayed fuel, and airflow will come inside this, and the mixture will happen inside this combustion chamber. And we have here ignition, spark ignition to start the burning the fuel. After that, after the burning, the flow will come here and enter the turbine. Look at the turbine. We have two movable parts, right? And we have two station parts. For example, if we look at this detailed view, this is the centrifugal compressor, and this is the turbine. The turbine, we have two stages. This is the first stage, stator and rotor. This is the second stage, stator and rotor. The first stage for the high pressure region, and the second stage for the low pressure region. Okay? First of all, we will start the engine. I will show you the procedures, the correct way to start the engine. After that, we will change the throttle value in the engine and to look at the parameter, the thermodynamic parameters, pressure and temperature inside these thermodynamic devices. After that, we will keep the throttle constant, and then we will study the outside parameters like the altitude, the speed, and the temperature around the airplane. Let us start how to run the engine. First of all, we should switch on the master key. Wait, we have here a manual panel. We can control this software using this manual panel. We have a master key there. Just switch it on. And you should wait until we reach to the steady state. Look at the pressure and the temperature, how they are increasing now, and wait until we reach to the steady state. Okay? And now, change the mode selector to the normal, this one. Okay, now we can increase the throttle as we need. In this situation, the throttle is 0%, right? Look at this. We have 0% throttle. Idle means once you ride the car, the car. Once you are in the car, you will put on the car, right? In this situation, you are the idle case. Without putting on the fuel pedal, without putting, this is the idle case. If you press on the pedal of the fuel, that means you increase the throttle. The throttle means the amount of fuel which go to the engine. Now, this indicator gives me the number of revolutions of the shaft. We have to spool, for example, in this shaft, the first one to rotate the high pressure, the second one to rotate the lower pressure. These are the number of revolutions per minute. How many revolutions per minute the engine is under operation? After that, increase the throttle knob, the big one. Yes. Put the throttle to anti-arbitrary. And change this to anti-arbitrary. Okay, at this situation, how much the throttle percentage? 32. How much the revolution per minute of the low pressure spool? 23,000 and almost 300, right? Revolution per minute. What about the high pressure spool? 34,000 and something, right? Okay. Back to the argument, to the argument, yeah, to the zero. Now in the zero situation, we should make a screenshot in your video for these two graphs or these two charts. After that, increase the throttle to NCR and look what happened to the temperature and the pressure. The green line presents the pressure parameters inside the thermodynamic devices, and the red line shows the temperature parameter inside the jet engine. Okay? So you should compare between the pressure and the temperature and the throttle and the number of the revolution at this level, and after that increase to the next level NCR, and look what will happen. And we can also increase the throttle to the top and look at the parameter what will happen inside the thermodynamic device. For example, if we take a look at the temperature during the compression, the compression increase, but a little amount, right? But regarding the pressure, it increases in a big amount, depends on the efficiency of the compression. And also here, if we look to the turbine, as we mentioned before, we have two stages, right? This is stage number one, stator. Rotor. Stage number two, stator and rotor. If we look to the first stator, the temperature and the pressure still remain constant. And the second, the rotor, and the first stage, the temperature decreases a little bit, but the pressure decreases in a big amount. This is called the expansion in the thermodynamics. The expansion means I decrease the pressure in a big amount, but Bernoulli says if you decrease the pressure, what will happen to the velocity? It will increase, generating a large amount of velocity to generate the thrust. The thrust is the force to push the airplane forward, right? So, decreasing the pressure will generate a high speedy flow. In this region and in this region, we have also a similar effect, but in a lower amount. This velocity to generate the thrust, and some of this energy will go back to run the compressor this way. Okay? Clear? Now, part number two, or the last step, we should keep the throttle at the top position and let us change the parameter outside the airplane. For example, increase the altitude of the airplane from 0 to 7,000, yeah, using this knob, yes, yes, increase it. And look what will happen here.
7,000?
Yes. Huge altitude. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay? This is the effect, so at a specific throttle value, you should compare between the pressure and the temperature for each stage or for each thermodynamic device. If we increase the altitude, what will happen? Reduce the altitude, make it zero. Okay? Again, increase the speed of the airplane to the full level. Yes, and look what will happen here. And also the last thing, decrease this and increase the temperature outside temperature. And look at the thermodynamic parameters. Yes, to the front. The pressure and temperature, what will happen inside the jet engine. Okay? Zero. We should compare all these parameters with the turbulence, as we mentioned before. The last thing I will show you how to shut down the engine. We should implement inverse sequence of the operating. So, first of all, we should decrease the total to idle level. Yes? After that, most selector put it on the start engine. Most selector. Yes, this one. The start engine. And the last thing, wait a little bit until all the readings go to the steady state situation, and after that, you can switch off the master plate. Yeah, you can switch it off. Rahim, switch off the master plate. Yes, sir. Now, you can stop recording if you want. Use this video to make a lot of snapshots. For example, for this, in this step, we change the value of the throttle, right?
Can I stop the video?
Yeah, you can stop it.